This is my brother Jared and myself. In December 2014, we decided to plan a trip to the Amazon because our lives needed a little adventure. So in March 2015, we called our friend Cecily and booked some tickets to Peru. Ten years ago, I lived in Peru as a missionary. I wasn't surprised to see that Lima is still a dangerous city, and that cab drivers sit in a cage to protect themselves. But the city has changed. It is cleaner now, and people are even starting to recycle. I've always liked how bright the buildings are in Peru. You can see that they have multiple layers. How it works is people begin with the first layer of their house, and then add on as their family grows. This is actually a fairly nice neighborhood where the houses are painted and have tile. We only had a few hours in Lima before it was time to get on a plane to Iquitos. Norma is the only female taxi driver in Iquitos, and she is also the only female taxi driver I ever met in Peru. She was so excited for us to see her beautiful city that she took us to all of the landmarks at no extra charge.
Iquitos. Hi, and what's your name?
Colleen.
Colleen, and where do we meet you?
On the plane.
Colleen got the traveling bug a few months ago and fell in love with South America. In fact, after we left, she took a 4-year apprenticeship to become a bamboo carpenter.
Yeah, instant friends.
Yeah.
What do you think of the jungle so far?
Oh, it's humid.
It's hot.
Jared doesn't like heat, humidity, or bugs, and you can see it on his face throughout the rest of the trip.
Oh, humid. Yeah. Okay, well, this of course is the airport, so.
Muchas motos aquí.
Bastante motos y motos.
There's the stairs that go up to
the ¿y cómo se llama esta calle?
Este lugar se hace el Giro Próspero, pues.
Okay. Ah.
La calle principal.
Sí.
Esa casa parece barco,
Ah, sí, parece barco. Ellos son los dueños de una compañía de lanchas, dice,
sí,
¿no?
De lanchas.
Bien. Ahí está.
People here say that Iquitos has more motorcycles and more mototaxis than any other city in the world. Iquitos has a real tropical feel. Everywhere you go, people will smile, wave. It is the friendliest city I've been to in this country. Another thing that's a lot of fun is people have a good sense of humor and you can joke around with anyone in the street. Cecily took a different plane than Jared and I did. So while he and I were exploring the city, Cecily was on a plane making friends with a local family. They invited us to dinner, we accepted, and they took us for a ride on their motorcycles.
In Iquitos at night.
There was a lot of nightlife in Iquitos. Maybe that's because it was the coolest part of the day. People were out in the street, restaurants were open, there were always concerts and dances going on, and there were plenty of street vendors like this lady selling emoliente, which is a thick drink made out of flaxseed.
Cecily, do you know where we are today?
Iquitos?
Yep.
With one of my good friends, Carmen, and...
Carmen?
Hola. Dania.
Oh.
Hey.
Telmo.
And...
The Diaz family is one of the nicest families you'll ever meet. After Cecily landed, they took her for a tour of their house and then a tour of the city. They own a local store that sells boat motors. When we left, they actually met us at the airport and said their goodbyes. I really appreciate my time with them and they made this trip memorable.
Una familia muy acogedora.
Sí.
Este es el Camu Camu? Camu Camu y Juane.
Juane is a traditional food from the jungle region of Peru. A lot of work goes into making Juane. The first step is to mix rice, vegetables, and roots to make a paste, and then that paste is wrapped around meat. Then, that meat is wrapped in either bijao or banana leaves. Then the entire bundle is steamed to perfection.
Y este es el Cecina con
Tacacho.
Tacacho, oh.
Tacacho is a very simple recipe. It's made out of mashed plantains, pork fat, and salt. That's it. But it is the perfect companion to go with Cecina, which is a smoked pork, and it has so much flavor that when you bite into it, the flavor seems to start on the tip of your tongue and go to the back of your mouth. And even when you've swallowed, you can still taste that amazing smoking, porky flavor.
Okay, so this is Paiche. which is one of the largest river fishes in the world, that, from my understanding. I think it's the biggest one in the Amazon. They can get up to 3 meters long.
Paiche is probably my favorite fish to eat. It has a bony skeleton, which means that there are no little bones to worry about. The texture is close to that of tilapia, yet it crisps up like a fresh salmon. We woke up early the next morning to a light and warm rain. During the whole trip, the temperature was about 80 degrees and the humidity was somewhere between 80 and 100%. I never stopped sweating and I took 2 to 3 showers a day. Leon was one of my favorite people that I met on the trip. His name fits him well because I think he is the king of the jungle. Everywhere we went, people knew him. He has spent his whole life out here. He is also an excellent spear fisherman. This is Leon's speedboat. We took it to get up the river up to the Tamshiaco. The first step of the journey was to go to a small village called Panguana, where we picked up fruit and other supplies. We saw less buildings the further we traveled from Iquitos, until eventually there were almost no buildings at all. For the first time we experienced the magnitude of the largest river in the world. Jasmine became a close friend during our trip. She planned every detail for us. The taxi, the hotel, our tour guide, even all of our meals. We also got the rare treat of celebrating her birthday with her. After we picked up our supplies, we got on the river, which looked more like an internal ocean in many areas. In fact, we even saw a few large barges and ocean liners. Eventually, we arrived at a tributary and began navigating our way through the trees until we arrived at the lodge. In all, it was a 3.5-hour journey.
Oh, it's a pretty cool trip.
Yeah, this is the people. Yeah, it's a tree.
Just arrived to the lodge. Coming out of that. Oh, look at that. Garza.
Yeah.
Ingrid.
Ingrid.
Okay.
Sí. Ella es la gran maloca. La maloca es una maloca difícil de construir y costosa de mantener porque tiene una punta.
I really loved being at the lodge. It was such a peaceful and secluded place. One of the best parts about being at the lodge is spending time with Leon's nephews and niece.
See? See?
This is where we celebrated Jasmine's birthday, ate the most amazing food I've ever had, and even got a little rest. But we didn't spend much time at the lodge, because there was too much adventure waiting for us outside. This is our jungle guide, Remy. We soon found out that we share an interest and love for animal and plant life. He was the one that made the trip unforgettable because of all the things he taught us about how the jungle works and what we can learn from it. Because we arrived in the rainy season, there are almost no areas to hike. Instead, we have to canoe almost everywhere we go. This area is a floodplain, and for miles and miles, there's nothing but water and trees. This tree is called Capirona. It is often considered a clean tree because it sheds its bark multiple times a year. The reason why it does this is it can defend itself against fungus and parasitic vines that are in the Amazon. This particular tree is probably sticking out of the water 60 feet, and there's probably another 10 to 15 feet underneath the water. This is an electric ant, or as they're called here, a tingotero. If you are stung by them, it feels like you've had an electric shock. And of course, one got in the boat, which Jared was not too excited about.
I'm just gonna knock him down.
Good, 3, 2, 1.
No! Oh, you knocked him in the boat!
Oh, no,
this is like Moby Dick right now. Kill it.
It seemed like everything got in the boat. We had beetles, spiders, termites, aphids, more spiders, even medicinal
ants. So this ant, if you smash it up and you put it around the edge of someone's nose, it'll relieve the symptoms of asthma.
This is called the bromeliad flower.
Remy explained that the bromeliad flower only grows on the tops of the trees because that's where the birds poop.
The leaves of this tree here in the center, the cecropia.
Local name is cetico.
Cetico? Look at this giant type of katydid.
My favorite bird on this journey was the Oropendola. The locals say it is the smartest bird of the jungle because it can imitate up to 100 other animals. Here are 3 different sounds that I recorded the bird making. Every venture from the lodge started with navigating our way through the thick part of the jungle in order to get out to a large tributary. Every time we left, the route was different, because the jungle is always changing and the water is moving the floating plants. At times, the rivers will actually change their flow due to the high or low flow of the other surrounding rivers. Remy's favorite animal is the Capuchin monkey. Every time we left the lodge, he said that we will do everything we can to find one.
Squirrel monkeys up there. It's probably too hard to see them. Oh, there's one. Oh, yeah, you can see them. They're just little. Squirrel monkeys. Okay.
Look, in the back is a baby.
Oh, I saw it. This is a plant here that they call lettuce, and it has some really interesting properties. One is that water repels right off of it because of some oil on the outside of it. So it's hydrophobic oil. Another thing is that they're full of oxygen that makes them float, and that's why the fish don't eat them. Because if they do, then they'll start to float. There are a couple animals like sea manatees that eat them without having much issues, or birds.
Here we're doing some piranha fishing. We have some meat on the end of a hook, and then we swish around the end of the pole in the water to try to mimic the sound of a dying fish. Remy actually caught one.
En Amazonas hay 25 a 26 especies de piranha. Este es uno de ellos. Es una piranha blanca.
What do you see, Jared?
That's a big spider.
Jared doesn't want to get too close.
And I just keep getting closer.
No le quiero lastimar porque no hay detectan la piel, quienes están nerviosos. Es momento, porque si estás nervioso lo vas a tirar o lo vas a apretar. Y en ese lapso sacan los dientes, son muy grandes, tienen 2 dientes muy grandes. Se inyecta el veneno, donde que te inyecta el veneno, se hace una especie de hematoma negro y posiblemente con el tiempo, si no te curas, se puede podrir esa parte.
Remy never stopped whistling to try to attract the Capuchin monkey, even when he was handling the large tarantula.
Look.
Ooh.
This is Miguel being crazy. There's a big jungle tarantula crawling on his back.
I'm actually shaking.
I'm shaking for you too.
Es una rana que es rana de Huama o rana de hoja. Suelen vivir acá en esta.
The Huama frogs have really distinct calls, and you'll actually be able to hear them in a lot of the other scenes.
We're looking for Caiman. Caiman, if we see any red glowing eyes with this flashlight, we know we got one.
Okay. 6 or 5 months. It's a baby.
The way you catch a caiman is you get close to it in your boat, then you reach out as fast as you can and grab it right behind the head. If you grab it too far forward or too far back, it'll bite you. One thing I wasn't expecting was how many spiders can swim in the Amazon. This spider swam into our boat. Before I knocked him out, Remy said, "Oh no, I want to show you how big its teeth are."
Tienen dientes muy grandes. Estos. Hasta ver lo que estás haciendo, porque ya me mordió varias veces y es muy doloroso. Mira, todo esto es el diente. Grandazo son.
Sí.
Y le presiona muy fuerte el palo y yo lo estoy jalando y no lo suelta.
Oh. Wow.
Y esto que te prende la piel, wow. Doloroso.
The rain's coming down really hard, getting on the camera, but here's another part of the jungle for you to see. It's a little different over here. We took the wrong route, so now we're trying to turn around. It's kind of hard to do a U-turn in these little rivers. So we're trying to do kind of a three-point turn here on this little offshoot of the river. I don't know how you can tell you're on the right route or wrong route, because this just looks like all jungle everywhere you go. So we got out of that little area trying to get out to this bigger offshoot of the river. This is all water underneath all these plants. And getting kind of stuck with them all and getting in the motor.
When the motor suena, it recalienta. It's on the rejillas. Que se tapa y no puede jalar agua para que refrigere.
So here we're in a deep part of the river. It's probably 6 or 7 meters deep. So all these trees that we see, we're just seeing the treetops. Giant lily pads. Those are like 3.5 feet wide. So here we can see the life cycle. This one's probably a month old, this little ball. And then it starts to spread after about a month and a half. And then 2 or 3 months it gets to this size until it gets to these large sizes here, as you can see. And they can live a few years. There's another interesting thing about it. There's holes throughout it, so you push down and it lets the water through. Then when you lift it up, the water drains. Which would make sense with all this rain here. We're trying to get from one lake to the next. We've been rowing through this. But this place is really cool. It has more of these palm-looking like trees. They have these really sharp spines on them that are about up to 4 inches long.
Okay, we just left the little river to change it out for the big river.
There he is. There he goes.
I got that.
It was.
Oh, mira, look. Oh.
The pink. Oh, that was the best one. That's the best.
Look.
Whoa.
little scary?
Oh yeah, that was scary. Just a little bit. Last night was towards the end.
This family caught an anaconda in one of their fishnets. Fortunately, when an anaconda is on the land, it doesn't have the same strength to overpower you as it would as if you were in the water. Once we were done with our photo shoot, the thing pooped on me.
Remy, ¿qué opinas de ayahuasca?
When we were in Iquitos, we met a few other tourists that were there to take the natural medicine, they kept saying. It took me a while to figure out that what they were talking about is ayahuasca, which is a vine that grows in the jungle. The best way to describe it is a jungle LSD. People grind it up, boil it for many hours, and then drink it. Soon after, they see visions and hallucinations, which is also accompanied by vomiting.
Pero para limpiar el cuerpo es como un laxante, digamos.
Sí.
Puede estar comprobado o no también, o sea, muchos no cuentan y los científicos de acuerdo a eso sacan también, ¿no? Ya es bueno para el cáncer, o sea, de acuerdo a eso el chamán, ¿no? Cree mucho en esa liana, ¿no? Y el paciente también va a creer bastante, una cosa milagrosa, ¿no? Que muchos se sanan, porque o sea, tiene fe en eso.
I really can't think of a worse place to be hallucinating. We had to be careful with every leaf and branch because we never knew what was hiding underneath it. Remy saw a sloth up in a tree, so he climbed up to grab it and threw it into the water. He assured us that this does not hurt the animal because this is one of their natural defense mechanisms. When they see a predator, they drop themselves into the water to escape. I was surprised at how stiff and sinewy his body is. They are such docile creatures, he almost had no reaction when I picked him up. Sloths are usually covered in moss and bugs because they are such slow animals they end up being a carrier for other things. Some tree parasites actually use sloths to get from one tree to another. This is a three-toed sloth. In fact, it is a male, and you can tell that by the stripe on its back. The diet of the sloths mainly consists of cecropia leaves. People here say that cecropia has an alcohol in it. According to them, it makes the sloths act like they're drunk. Either way, they have a very slow metabolism, and it takes all day for them to digest their food.
Dry out in the sun.
Acrobat.
Yeah, I'd say.
Remy was pretty happy that we were able to see the sloth. However, he said he would not be satisfied until he finds us a Capuchin monkey.
Right now we're looking for some dry land. The jungle's just so thick here, it's hard to get anywhere. Plus the other issue is, it's place is just one giant lake. I don't know how far we'll have to go to find land.
We finally found a part of the jungle that was not underwater. It was hotter here, more humid, and there were a lot more bugs. This is the Ceiba. It is the largest tree in the jungle. They can grow up to 230 feet tall. Remy's testing the vines to see which ones can hold our weight. And obviously that last one couldn't.
Yeah.
This was a childhood dream come true. Dead trees rot so quickly here that they will completely disappear and leave large holes in the ground.
Let's walk along here and start looking at a branch and see this big hole here. My leg went all the way in, didn't even touch the bottom. This is what makes the jungle fun. I'm loving it.
I should have seen come through this at night. It's pretty wild.
Speaking of nighttime, the night before, Jared and I were in bed when something from the water hit the supporting column of the lodge and shook it with so much force that it woke us up. We never figured out what the animal was. I never felt scared in the jungle. However, I've always heard that everyone that's ever lived in the jungle has many stories about tunches, which are jungle spirits, or even worse things like pistacos, which are men or some say even demons, that kidnap you in the night and harvest the fat from your body.
We went at just the right place. Any further back and we would have been stuck in all the Huama.
Sometimes the sounds of the Amazon could be deafening.
Termite nest.
This is the Asula, or bullet ant. According to the Schmidt scale, it has the most painful sting out of any insect in the world. In fact, it feels like you've been shot by a bullet for 2 days straight. Here Remy is pulling out the stinger to make the ant relatively harmless. As soon as Remy applied the sap to our bug bites, they stopped itching.
We're just talking about how there's just no straight path in this place. And it's so confusing. If I were to try and find my way back, there's no way. It says every direction I go, I'll just hit water. But it won't be where we came from.
This is the Yarina. It is also called a jungle coconut.
Oh wow. It's a really thick gelatin. Almost no flavor. What does it taste like?
It's kind of gross.
The wood from the chonta tree is often used to build houses here because it is resistant to rotting in the Amazon water.
The flower?
Good.
Ahí está. We found it there.
Contacto con otro árbol.
de Palo Santo, según los biólogos. Porque no tiene contacto, mira, todo está libre. Porque estos hormigas que cuida acá el contorno.
The ants in the tree have a symbiotic relationship. The tree provides a home for the ants, which have a burning sting that they use to defend anything that touches the tree. The tree in front is another chonta. The one behind it is called a walking palm. It walks by sprouting new roots in the direction that it wants to move. It can move up to 20 inches a year by doing this. This is the shell of a land snail. It was probably eaten by a large lizard.
A worm? It's a leech.
What does it eat, that leech?
Maybe it eats
a tree?
No. Caiman.
Cat's claw is a vine that is used as medicine by native tribes. It is also gaining popularity in the US as a nutraceutical. It tasted like water with a slight hint of aspen leaves. Well, it's time to head back to the lodge, and Jared probably couldn't be any happier. He didn't like how hot it was and all of the bugs that were there attacking us the whole time.
Leon was busy while we were gone.
Leon offered to teach me how to spearfish. I had a little beginner's luck.
They're pointing towards the camera.
But just a little luck.
Just cut my spines. Fish bone, so it's easier to eat.
That's right, fresh after a rain.
Say.
We had such an amazing time in the Tamshiaku. However, I felt that Remy was just a little bit disappointed that we never saw a capuchin monkey. Peru is on the western side of South America, and the Amazon River flows all the way from Peru to the Atlantic Ocean. Many of these ocean liners could have come from Brazil or even further away. As soon as we got to the port, I knew I was going to miss the fresh air of the jungle and all of the adventures that we had there. However, it was a good opportunity to nurse my bug buds. Belen is also called Little Venice, and it is one of the poorest parts of the city.
Yeah. I really got to like the ride.
Some of the houses are built on stilts, while other houses float on top of the water. This bike shop is still full of tools even though it's flooded. During the wet season, they can still access the tools by canoe, and during the summer season, they can actually work in the shop. Berlin is like so many open markets in Peru. You can get anything there, whether it's electronics, food, clothes. I even found a spell called pusanga that is used to make someone fall in love with you. This is a local delicacy. It's called suri. It is a grub that feasts on dead trees.
Okay, go for it. Good? Wow.
Best ever.
Okay, Jared, go for it.
Just
go for it. Not bad?
At least that's what he said until he tried to swallow. I think they have the consistency of sausage, but the head kind of has that crunch like an empty popcorn shell. It's a little disgusting.
Our job here is we rescue those animals from people that try to keep as a pet. Here, they're going to pass for a recovering process and then we're going to release them into the wild, but in protected areas.
These are leafcutter ants. They actually do not eat the leaves, instead they take them back to their nest where they have their fungus garden. The leaves are food for the fungus, and the fungus is food for the ants. This is the elusive Capuchin monkey, the monkey that Remy so badly wanted us to see. It had escaped from his cage and we found it before any of the zookeepers did. We did our best to try and get it to come over and play with us. Jared has always been an animal lover, but I don't think he was ready for this.
That's weird. Is he soft?
I'm sticking his fingers in my ear.
He has his foot in your face. Okay, he's coming home with us.
Oh. The whole time we were in the jungle, we were looking for a capuchin monkey, and I'm glad we finally got to see one before we left.